Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Hamworld team, I might say how pleased we are to visit your part of the world. And we hope that you're going to enjoy what we have in store. And we're going to start as usual. I'm going to introduce each ringer individually, and then we'll take it from there. So we'll start with our bass ringer, John. Michael. Charles. Stephen. Jeffrey. Henry. Adrian. Brian. Brother Brian. Donald. Dennis. And Barry. And from there, we go into our signature tune, Cubbly Brook. Matter of interest, ladies and gentlemen, that particular melody is being played from the Californian coast right across the states. The numbers of copies that I've dispatched to America has become even as popular over there as it is here. And Cubbly Brook is very well known, which is a good thing for Nelsonville Orchestra. Well now, our first item proper, speaking of the United States, is one of Sousa's perhaps the most famous march, in my opinion, that he wrote, The Stars and Stripes Forever.
Thank you.
now something rather quieter. One that I used to take as a piano lesson as a small boy, Leroy Anderson's Forgotten Dreams. Amazing how the simple pieces seem to demand as much applause as the rather difficult ones that we seem to struggle with at rehearsal. You take them into concert, and a simple little piece seems to attract equally. So I don't know why we tackle difficult pieces. Well, here's one of those amongst us who remember Russ Conway. I don't know how he managed with the end of his finger missing, but he did, and this is one of his pieces, Roulette. Thank you. as a matter of interest to you, ladies and gentlemen, maybe you're wondering how many bulbs we have, etc. We often get asked these questions. We have about 140 on the table tonight, and 88 of them are at this side, which means these four gentlemen have roughly 89, I'm told now, roughly 22 each. And, well, as you've seen during a concert, they're all used. Well, now, try as I might, can never keep Strauss, Johann Strauss, out of our programs. I don't desire to do, by the way, but as a change from the waltzes, which he is famous for his waltzes, we've put together a selection of polkas, and with that title, selection of polkas by Strauss.
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, for our first item, we go back to Johann Strauss and the polka, Tristrasse polka. The question, are the birds reaching the back? Can you hear them? Fine. We can play a bit louder. Well now, this is something you'll have to listen with both ears as opposed to the one. It's a very gentle piece, but nonetheless very attractive. Carry on. Thank you. we're going to try something different now. A short while ago I was handed a piece of music, a Glenn Miller arrangement, but in about an orchestra of different instruments of different pitches, and it was quite a problem, but it, I did salvage something from it. But I ask you, how do they write a glissando, which is on a trombone? How do you do it on handbells? Can anybody tell me? No, no, it's not possible. So we have put together what we think is possible for handbells, and Glenn Miller's in the mood. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, that was the first public performance. And I haven't... I'm waiting to hear if I know of one handball team in the country that maybe we shall be hearing from them, that I did hand a copy to, and hopefully we shall hear it from them in the near future. Well now, at the moment I think I should tell you a little bit about these fellas. We are a very closely knit group, you've probably heard some of you. If we start with Barry here, he has his brother Geoffrey. And next to Geoffrey is his cousin, Henry. Then we come to Dennis. and his son Brian, who married Donald's daughter. And they are now granddads. No, they don't look it, don't they? Couple of granddads. Now we come to Brian. Next to him is Brian's youngest son, Adrian. And the way over here, the elder, Stephen. So there's father and two sons here. And here, well, what can we say about these except the three odd ones? Well, now, this is something that I haven't heard. Anyway, I heard some arrangement of black and white rag, but this is, those of you who remember Winnie Atwill, the Connacht pianist, she died not very long ago anyway, on the honky-tonk, a bit like Russ Conway. And this is her arrangement of the black and white rag. Those who have watched snooker, what is it, Pot Black? This is what they always play at the beginning of Pot Black. Interesting point that I haven't mentioned is our two bottom bass wells, the two buckets here, are both gifts from the American anvil world, of which we're great friends with. And at today's prices, well, there wouldn't be much change from about £600 for the two. You might get a bit, but not a lot. As Paul Daniel says, not a lot. Well now, we come to the parade of the tin soldiers. Bottom base well, the base wells, the two buckets here, are both gifts from the American anvil world, of which we're great friends with. And at today's prices, well, there wouldn't be much change from about £600 for the two. You might get a bit, but not a lot. As Paul Daniel says, not a lot. Well now, we come to the parade of the tin soldiers. Thank you. Well, our next item, ladies and gentlemen, is I first heard an American organist playing this particular piece by the name of Ethel Smith. And I thought, good, why, that would make a lovely piece for handbells if we could play it. Anyway, here's the result. Tico, tico. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Well, to commence this part of the programme, ladies and gentlemen, if I say, shall we go to the circus, you'll probably realise this, when the clowns come bouncing into a circus ring, this is the melody that you probably hear. Entry of the gladiators. Thank you. next item are two together from Brahms. And if you're next, the people sat at the side of you, if they drop off, just nudge them. It does include Brahms Lullaby. And if I drop off, somebody kick me up. I'm very quiet. I see our next item is from none of the great masters, this time Mozart. And this is the Rondo alla Turca. Thank you. these poor at this side feel a bit swollen headed, but really that was their piece. I think it demonstrated that you can't think of anything while you're on doing this job. That's fatal. The mind has to be on. Not too long. Well now, this is something different. Different rhythm. Granada. You know, ladies and gentlemen, with my job, especially at practice as rehearsals, you go home spitting feathers, and the wife will say, "Have you had a rough time?" I'll say, "Well, pretty." And it makes you wonder sometimes, is it all worthwhile? But you know, when you come and hear an appreciative audience, the answer is there, yes it is. Thank you. I think we have just room for about half a dozen volunteers. This is the can-can. And if we have any volunteers, we can shift this thing.
Just says, do you think they'd like an encore? I think the answer is yes.
Well, it's my bedtime. Fortunately, we have one with us. And it is the celebrated and the famous 12th Street Rag. You like me whistle? Thank you. gentlemen, can I just say on behalf of these bonny lads that I think we've enjoyed it as much as you. Because if you don't enjoy it, well, you're wasting your time. An unhappy ringer, if you've one that's not happy with his job, it's fatal. You've all got to love it. And we hope sometime in the future we shall travel again down to Colchester. It's our first visit, and unfortunately, daylight this time of the year, we haven't been able to have a walk round and view the place, but maybe another time. Until then, we hope you all have a safe journey home. We do. Yes. And see you next time. Thank you.